Hello and welcome to another video of Des Illustrates. In this video we're again looking at a lot of butterflies. I'm still in the middle of the Love Butterfly Challenge, but I'm enjoying it a lot, and after this vlog I just finished the 11th butterfly of the challenge and I have 4 more to go, so I think by the time the next vlog comes out, I have finished all the butterflies. And to be honest, even though this challenge was a lot of fun, and it was a lot of fun to do it with all those other people that also painted some really beautiful butterflies, I am also ready to paint some other subjects again. The first butterfly was a plain butterfly. I had loads of fun painting that one, and I must say that since I painted that one after the Monarch was a bit of a struggle and I also didn't really like that one, the plain butterfly was the one that I got my painting feeling, or whatever I want to call it, I got it back again. And the next butterfly, like this one, the Malachite, or the Malachite, I'm not sure how to pronounce that one, and the Imperial Sunstreak, I believe it was called, the next one, they came much easier again. So it looked like I had a bit of a struggle in the middle of the challenge with the Monarch on its depth, and with the large striped swallowtail I already felt a bit better again, but it was only with the plain butterfly that I really felt, okay, I got this again. So yeah, that was a bit of a struggle in the middle. But I'm happy that I went through with the challenge. And to be honest, this challenge is the one I got the furthest with. I have in the past tried other challenges, but often failed really early in the challenge to keep up, and I put too much pressure on myself to finish all the paintings and to make them full-on illustrations with backgrounds and everything. And with these I kept it really loose for myself, and I also said, if you can't make it on time, that's fine. You're a day late, or maybe in the end you're a week late, but you're still doing it and it will be fine. So by taking away the pressure and by just making it like vintage illustrations out of those books where you can identify butterflies with, I made it easier for myself. And in the end, I'm really happy with how I painted them, because now I can make maybe some big poster plate designs where you can hang them on your wall and they say butterflies from around the world, and you have a bunch of them on there. Like, it's one of those real old vintage illustrations out of one of those books. And I also maybe want to make some stickers and some sticker sheets, so we will see what I can do. And some of them already are on Patreon. I cleaned up some of the paintings and made them into printable stickers and postcard prints. So you can, if you are a member on Patreon, you can download them and print them yourself at home. So that's a nice perk that I uploaded on Patreon. The butterfly that we are painting right now was the first butterfly that was as green as this one. So I was a bit in doubt on how to build up the color, because like I said in my last vlog, I was really struggling with the blue butterflies, and I was afraid that I was gonna have the same problem with this green and black butterfly, because it was, in the photo, it was reasonably flat. There wasn't much tone and or depth difference in the black. And also the green was just a really vibrant popping green, and sometimes if something works in a photo, it doesn't mean that it works in an illustration, because in a photo we know that it's supposed to be, it's a photograph of a real butterfly, and in your brain and your eye accepts that it's real faster. But if we paint something, it's an illustration, and it's easier to make something in an illustration that isn't there. So it's harder to make it look like it's real in an illustration sometimes. I've seen that before in reference pictures of dogs. If you, for example, have one that you're looking down on the dog, that one is really hard to paint, because the angle of where the dog is in, where the body is further away than the head, that's just, if you paint it in an illustration, it looks wrong, while in the picture it looks completely fine. So not every picture that you find or that you take is suitable for illustration. And I really had that with this butterfly too. So what I ended up doing was bringing much more depth in both the body and the wings of the butterfly by not making everything flat black. I kept a lot of it lighter of the gray, and I brought the patterns in the wings that I was really seeing really vaguely. I brought that more to life and more to the foreground, that it was more visible that those patterns were there in the black wings. And in the end, I'm really happy that I did that, even though it was more work than if I had just painted it straight black. But I am happy that it's way more interesting to look at right now than if I had painted it just straight black. I am a little bit curious how many of you also are painting this butterfly challenge. Let me know down below in the comments if you do. And also let me know if I, at the end of this challenge, would make not really a tutorial, but a video about the little things to watch about when you're painting butterflies and the things that could help you, almost a bit like tips and tricks and in a kind of vlog style video. What would you like to see in a video like that? Are there certain parts of butterflies you really struggle with, or really typical colors that you are struggling with that you would like to see me explain a bit or show you how I do it more in depth? Because I'm thinking about making one of those videos with some of the footage that I have from all these butterflies, but also maybe painting one additional one where I show more in depth, for example, the body of the butterfly and how I use the basic anatomy of butterflies that's almost the same in every butterfly to paint in the things that I don't see in the pictures and stuff like that. So definitely let me know in the comments if you would like a video like that and what you would like to see in a video like that. I would really appreciate some input about that. During this challenge and painting all these butterflies, a lot of things that I already did became really clear to me, why I do them and how I do them, and that I have a really set way on starting illustrations, and that I have a go back of knowledge of anatomy of certain things that helps me to fill in the blanks from stuff that I can't see in the pictures, for example. Now, of course, I still have stuff to learn myself. For example, in the blue butterflies, I had so much struggle with that, and I talked about that in my last vlog. And I noticed in the new blue butterfly that I painted after this one, I believe, that it came a lot easier to me, that blue butterfly. I didn't struggle so much with the color of the blue and the tone, and I also managed to put some more details in the blue, and that's something I really grew in. And I think part of the problem was that there aren't a lot of animals in general that are blue, so it's not a color that I've painted with a lot. Earth tones and blacks and grays, I know my way around those. I have painted a lot with them, and I know how to enhance them a bit and how to use yellows and purples and highlights and shadows to make paintings more interesting and give them more depth. But blue is just a color that I have hardly painted with ever. So I think that's part of the problem. And a different part in the beginning of the challenge was that I didn't have that much blues in my palette, especially cool blues. It's because I almost never use them. And halfway the challenge, I got the new palette, the Van Gogh palette. And there are some more blues on that palette that I didn't have. And they definitely helped me with the next few blue butterflies. But I didn't really understand that palette yet, because it was new and it had new colors that I had never painted with yet. So it took me a few paintings to get it right. But yeah, I'm happy that I kept on it and that I now feel more comfortable painting with blues. After this challenge, I definitely am going to paint some other subjects first before I go back to the butterflies. One of the things I'm really missing in painting is painting with gouache and painting birds. So I'm curious if there's anything you are looking forward to seeing me paint, or a subject that you would really love to see some details from how I paint them and how I built up my colors or how I built up the fur or anything like that. So is there anything that you would really love to see me paint and that you would love to see a video or a vlog about? Let me also know that down below in the comments, and I will see if I can make it happen. I do want to make more videos in a tutorial-like style in the future, but I think I'm not there yet with my video quality and also with my voiceover quality to make it like I want it to be. So that would just be a lot of frustration. So videos like that would just be in a kind of vlog style like this, or more how I do it and not a step-by-step tutorial. I don't have a very clear picture yet of what I want exactly with these videos and how I want to set them up, but I definitely want to go and try film them and to try to make voiceovers for them that make sense about the subject. And I'm just looking for what people want, because I can make videos that I like and that I think would be fun, but in the end of the day it's about what people want, because I can like it, but if nobody else is liking it, then nobody is gonna watch it. So definitely do let me know whatever you like to see as a subject, and both in watercolor or in gouache, or even in watercolor pencils or aqua markers. I enjoy working in them all myself, and I also enjoy a really wide variety of subjects. I don't think there is an animal that I have painted so far that I didn't like. Some do take me a lot longer to paint than others. For example, fur takes me longer to paint than feathers. Feathers come really easily to me somehow. And now with all these butterflies I have been practicing, and also a lot of bugs, those also come reasonably easy to me to paint. I would not say that I don't struggle with them sometimes, but if I have to say which ones is the easiest for me to paint, then it would be definitely birds and insects. But that doesn't mean that I don't enjoy the other ones. I just haven't had that much practice with them. I mostly painted or colored fur with colored pencils, but I can't really do that anymore. So I still have to find my way with making fur look just as good and detailed in watercolors. And something else that I really enjoy painting are reptiles. I just love the scales and the variety that you can make in the colors and the shadows that fall under the scales. And yeah, you can be really creative with them and the colors that you are using. So it's a nice subject to paint. A last thing that I want to mention in this video is that there is a nature artist Facebook group on Facebook that Allison and I made. Allison is the one behind the Love Butterfly Challenge. We would love to see you there and to see all your work, all your butterflies or other paintings. Even other mediums are welcome, including digital artwork. And yeah, it's just a really lovely group that's in the starting up phase, but we are exciting to make it something more and to make it something bigger. That is a really nice, lovely community. So we hope to see you there. With that, we are almost at the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed watching it, and if you did, leave a like and subscribe. I want to thank you very much for watching, And I also want to thank my Patreons, Hans, Barozu, Gris, and Allison. And I hope to see you all next time. Bye!